Hello, everyone. Mastering stable diffusion SDXL LoRA training can be a daunting challenge, especially for those passionate about AI art and stable diffusion. But fear not. If you're eager to unlock the full creative potential of LoRA and AI art, we have the perfect tutorial for you. In this YouTube video, we'll take you step by step through the stable diffusion SDXL LoRA training process, empowering you to create mesmerizing AI art like never before. So, if you're ready to dive into the world of stable diffusion and elevate your AI art with LoRA, stay tuned and let's embark on this exciting journey together. I have tested 6 different settings with different batch sizes and network dimensions, and record the system RAM usage, VRAM usage, and the time taken for each test. And these are the settings I used in this video. You can find this information in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description below. Today we will go through the steps to train the SDXL LoRA model on Windows. It's the same on Linux Ubuntu. We will use the SD scripts by kohya-ss to train the SDXL LoRA model. These are the steps we will go through today. First, we download the SD scripts repository. Next, I will show you how to check out the branch that contains the training scripts. We will create a virtual environment to install the required packages, and then we need to activate it. When we are in the virtual environment, we need to install the PyTorch version that worked. After that, we can install the requirements for the SD scripts. I will also show you how to set the configuration files. After all these steps, we can start training. Okay, let's start. First, we need to clone the SD scripts repository. To do this, click the code and copy the repository URL. I will clone it in the C drive. Open a command prompt and type git clone, and then the repository URL. Press enter. The codes will be downloaded to your hard drive. I will put the folder in my workspace. Let's see what's inside. There are the original LoRA training scripts. Change in directory to the SD script folder, because we are in the main branch. To get the SDXL training scripts, we need to check out the SDXL branch. To do this, type git checkout SDXL. Okay, you will now see all those SDXL training scripts. We will use the script to train our LoRA model. Next, we will create a new virtual environment. Type python-m venv, and then venv. When it is finished, you will see there is an additional folder here. Before installing anything, we need to activate the virtual environment first. To activate, type venv flash scripts flash activate thaw vat. Okay, you can see that there is a venv in the front. That means we are in a virtual environment. We are going to install the PyTorch. We will install version 1.12.1. Find the pip command. Copy the command for CUDA 11.6. In the terminal, paste the command to install. When it is finished, we will install the requirement for SD scripts. Type pip install -r requirements daw txt. Okay. Because we are not using any UI, we need to set the training parameters ourselves in 3 config files. I have already created a folder in C drive to store all these things. We will have a folder to store the training dataset images with the captions. And those 3 config files. Let's see what those config files are. This is the folder to store the training images and captions. This is the dataset config. We can set the resolutions of the dataset images here. Also, we need to set the file path of the folder that stores the training images and captions here. Set the caption extension here. For this training, I will repeat the images 27 times. OK. For the training parameters, we have another file. The first line here is to set the checkpoint that we want to train from. The second line set the file path of the previous dataset config file. Line 3 set the sample prompt file. Inside the prompt file, we set the positive prompt and negative prompt for the sample images generated during the training, separated by minus minus m. The output directory set the location to store the trained LoRA model files. The log directory set the location the log will write. The output name is the LoRA model file name. We set the batch size, network dimension, and network alpha here. Recently, the training script supported the settings of training steps. We do not need to set the number of training epoch. Instead, we can set the training steps we want. We can also set the sampling frequency and the frequency to output the LoRA models here. The optimizer type is the optimizer that we want. This time I use Ada Factor. If you want to use Atom 8-bit, you set it here. For the network train unit only, I set it to true because there are two text encoders in SDXL. Kohya suggested that we train the unit only, so set it to true here. Learning rates are set here. Xformers. On Windows, I set it to false because there is an error if I set it to true. But on Linux, I can set it to true. For SDXL, we have to use NoHaVE. When these three config files are all set, we can call the training scripts. How to call the scripts? It's not difficult. We use accelerate to call the SDXL train network scripts, with a config file argument set to our config file path. OK. Copy the command. Inside the SD scripts directory, paste the command to start training. I have tested 6 different settings, with different batch sizes and network dimensions, and record the system RAM usage, VRAM usage, and the time taken for each test. And these are the settings I used in this video. You can find this information in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description below. Hey there! If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. Okay. No problem. It started to train. You can find the training information above. Our dataset parameters. We have 20 training images. 27 times 20 equals 540. Resolution. Where is the dataset images? Num repeat. I don't know why the resolution here is 512 times 512. The base model. The models are loaded. Latent cache. Text encoders are cached. Create LoRA network. And it started to train here. It will train 1620 steps as I have specified the amount of steps. Okay. After 30 minutes, the training is finished. You can find 10 LoRA models and samples here. These are the sample images. It started to look like the object after 60 and 20 steps. To use the LoRA models, copy and paste them to the Stable Diffusion LoRA Models folder. Try the last output. We first test the image without the LoRA model. Change the dimension to 1024x1024. Generate. Okay, it looks like this. Reuse the seed. This time add our LoRA model. With weight 0.8. Generate. It looks pretty good. This is the SDXL LoRA. Observation. Using the settings in this video, the results are not realistic enough for me. Maybe it needs a fine-tuned checkpoint in order to have better results. On Windows, the training time is double the time I used in Ubuntu with the same settings. Also, XFormers cannot be used on Windows. Conclusion. So now you know how to train the SDXL LoRA model. Find the parameters that work for you and start training today. Happy training. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about Stable Diffusion and LoRA training, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.